इंडिया पोस्ट इंडिपेंडेंस रेमनेंसेस एंड पॉलिटिकल थॉट्स लेटर 14 डियर फ्रेंड्स एंड सिस्टर्स आई टॉक टू यू इज माणक चंद संगी फ्रॉम बेंगलोर कर्नाटका स्टेट। राजीव गांधी वॉज द सिक्स्थ प्राइम मिनिस्टर ऑफ इंडिया 1984 to 1989। ही टुक ऑफिस आफ्टर हीज मदर्स असैसिनेशन On 31st October 1984, he was the youngest Prime Minister of India at the age of 40. Indian National Congress Party leaders nominated him as a candidate of Prime Minister. During 1984 parliamentary elections, Rajiv Gandhi led the Congress Party to a major election victory in the Indian Parliament, winning 411 Parliament seats as against of 542 in total. On an economic front, he took the bold step to dismantle license Raj, government quota tariffs and permit Raj. He modernized the telecommunications industry, the education system and improved relations with the United States. These efforts led to all-around development in the country. Simultaneously, people at large wanted this change to a great degree of development. Rajiv Gandhi reversed the COP in Maldives in 1988, antagonizing the militant Tamil outfits such as Plotty. He sent Indian peacekeeping force IPKF for protecting Tamil communities' interests at large in majority Sinhalese populace in Sri Lanka in 1987. This is meant for maintaining peace initiatives. This evoked an open conflict with the Liberation Tigers of Tamil Eelam. His clean, corruption-free image broke out on surfacing of Buffer's gun scandal. This had resulted in a major defeat for Congress Party in the parliament elections of 1989. Rajiv Gandhi allowed Shilanyas or a groundbreaking ceremony in undisputed site close to the structure at Ayodhya. During Rajiv Gandhi period, Bharatiya Janata Party won 120 seats in 1981 from two parliament seats in 1984. Rajiv Gandhi remained Congress president until the primary parliamentary elections in 1991. He was assassinated by Liberation Tiger of Tamil Eelam. Rajiv Gandhi was posthumously awarded the highest national award of India, Bharat Ratna, in 1991. He founded INTAC in 1984 that seeks to preserve India's art and cultural heritage. His maternal grandfather was the Indian independence leader Jawaharlal Nehru, who was India's first Prime Minister after independence. This is to know that Rajiv Gandhi worked with Indian Airlines as a professional pilot. His mother was Prime Minister in 1966. But he had no interest in country's politics and did not live regularly with his mother in Delhi at Prime Minister's residence in 1970. It is known that his younger brother Sanjay Gandhi, who was very close to his mother Indira Gandhi and was then taking close participation in active politics. Sanjay Gandhi died in 1980 due to unknown reasons. Hence, Indian National Congress Party politicians pressurized Rajiv Gandhi and his mother to enter politics. Rajiv Gandhi and his wife Sonia Gandhi were both opposed to the idea. He himself publicly said that he would not contest for his brother's seat, but afterwards he announced his candidacy for parliament seat. His entry was criticized by many in the press, public and opposition political parties. Rajiv Gandhi became member of the Asian Games Organizing Committee in 1982 with his close friend Sardar Bhoota Singh, then sports minister, as president of the committee. Rajiv Gandhi fought his first parliamentary election from Amethi Lok Sabha constituency in Uttar Pradesh in February 1981. Rajiv Gandhi had become an important political advisor to his mother Indira Gandhi. It was widely perceived that Indira Gandhi opts for PM's job for Rajiv Gandhi. Rajiv Gandhi had then become the president of the Youth Congress Party's wings. I recollect that he had founded the Jawahar Navoday Vidyalaya system in 1986. It is a central government-based institution that emphasizes more on the upliftment of the rural section of the society, providing them free residential education from 6th to 12th standard. He established MTNL in 1986 and his public call offices, better known as PCOs. This helped spread telephones in rural areas. He introduced measures significantly reducing the license raj. In his past 1990 period, he had allowed business and individuals to purchase capital consumer goods and import without bureaucratic restrictions. Rajiv Gandhi established the foreign policy significantly different from his mother's socialism. He improved bilateral relations with the United States, which were strained due to Indira Gandhi's socialism and friendship with USSR. He had expanded economic and scientific cooperation with the US and the Western countries. Rajiv Gandhi authorized an extensive police and army campaign to contain terrorism in the state of Punjab. A state of martial law existed in the Punjab, and civil liberties, commerce and tourism were greatly disrupted. It was understood that there were many accusations of human rights violations by police officials as well as by the militants during this period. Anyhow, the situation in Punjab came to in control. It is said that Indo-Sri Lanka Peace Award was signed by Sri Rajiv Gandhi, the Sri Lankan President J.R. Jayawardhane in Colombo on 29 July 1987. I remember that on the very next day, Rajiv Gandhi was assaulted on the head with a rifle butt by a young Sinhali naval candidate while receiving Guard of Honor. The intended insult on the back of the Rajiv Gandhi's head glanced off his shoulder. The press and the video captured the incident and it was widely televised. I remember the important event that has happened when Rajiv Gandhi gave his speech while addressing the joint session of the US Congress and India. He had expressed as such, India is an old country but a young nation. And like the young everywhere, we are impatient. I am young and I have a dream. I dream of an India strong, independent, self-reliant and the forefront of the front ranks of the nations of the world in the service of mankind. Rajiv Gandhi's clean image diminished when buffer scandal surfaced during his tenure. This involved tens of millions of dollars of payoffs made by the Swedish buffer arms company, Sweden to Gandhi family associate Ottavi Kartorochi. This was in return for Indian contract first for sale of buffer guns supplied by Buffer's arm company to Indian Army. Rajiv Gandhi himself was later personally implicated in the scandal when further investigation was made. This had shattered his image as an honest, punished politician. He was posthumously cleared over this allegation in 2004. It is said the Supreme Court of India ruled in favor of Muslim divorcee Sah Bhano, declaring that her husband should give her alimony. But Muslim fundamentalists in India treated as an encroachment in Muslim personal law and protested against it. Rajiv Gandhi agreed to their demands. In 1986, the Congress Party, which had an absolute majority in Parliament that at that time, passed an act to nullify the Supreme Court's judgment in Sah Bhano case. This was viewed by many in India, including the Bharatiya Janata Party, as an appeasement of Muslims. It is further alleged that Rajiv Gandhi held 2.5 million Swiss francs in secret Indian accounts in Switzerland. I feel that in democracy, such false allegations are made by opposition parties and others which do not have any base of truth. Rajiv Gandhi studied the India's culture and heritage very closely when he grew mature in his last political period. I saw his many interviews on TV and listened very carefully, which made me very influenced by his pleasant personality and humor. He was a son of great India, and millions of Indians do not forget him. He traveled far-flung areas of India, that is, villages, taluks, districts, and backward areas of cities of this country. He interacted millions of people from lower to upper ups and known very closely. You know that why Narendra Modi has won millions of hearts of our people, because he traveled lakhs of kilometers to interact with them and compared for himself as PM of this country. Jai Hind! I request you to get peace and repeat the following with me. Vaheguru, Vaheguru, Vaheguru Ji, Vaheguru, Vaheguru, Vaheguru Ji, Vaheguru, Vaheguru, Vaheguru Ji, Vaheguru, Vaheguru, Vaheguru Ji, Om Namo Shivaya, Om Namo Shivaya, Om Namo Shivaya, Om Namo Shivaya, Hare Ram, Hare Ram, Ram Ram, Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Ram, Ram Ram, Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Ram, Ram Ram, Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Ram, Ram Ram, Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare. Om Sri Venkateshaya Namah, Om Sri Venkateshaya Namah, ओम श्री वेंकटेशाय नमः, ओम श्री वेंकटेशाय नमः।